Hello everyone, this is Manisha Khare from Sri Vaishnav Institute of Forensic Science. My topic is pattern of fingerprint. First, if we talk about what is fingerprint. Fingerprint identification is the method of identification using the impression made by the manager each formation or pattern found on the fingertips. No two persons have actually the same arrangement of ridge patterns, and the pattern of any individual remains unchanged throughout life. Fingerprints offer an invaluable means of personal identification. Other personal characteristics may be changed, but fingerprint. Next point is uses of fingerprint providing biometric security, for example, to control access to secure areas or system, identifying initial victim and unknown disease, conducting background checks, including application for government employment. There is a main type of manusha. First is ridge ending, bifurcation, ridge crossing, hook, double bifurcation, core delta, and short ridge and bridge. There is three main type of fingerprint pattern. First is arches, loops, and whorl. First, if we talk about arches, this occurred in about 5% of the encountered fingerprint. The ridges of the finger run continuously from one side of the finger to the other and make no backward turn. Normally, there is no delta in an arch pattern, but if it exists, there must be recurving ridge that intervals between the core and delta. Subcategories of arches. First is plain arch. In this pattern, a consistency of flow can be observed. It starts on one side of the finger and the ridge then slightly upward. This almost resembles a wave out on the oceans, and then arch continues its journey along the finger to the. The plain arch pattern is the simplest of the fingerprint. Second is tented arch. The similarity between this pattern and the plain arch is that it starts on one side of the finger and flows out to the other side in a similar pattern. However, the difference is that the tented arch lies in the ridges in the center and is not continuous like the plain arch. They have slightly up thrust in the ridges near the middle that arrange themselves on the both sides. Second pattern is loops. This can be seen in almost 60 to 70% of the fingerprint that are encountered. The ridges make a backward turn in loop, but they do not. This backward turn or loops is distinguished by how the loop flows on the hand and not by how the loop flows on the card where the imprint is taken. The imprint on the fingerprint is similar to the reverse image that we see when we look at the ourselves in the mirror. A loop pattern has only subcategories of loop. First is radial loop. These loops are named after a bone is the forearm known as radius that to join the hand on the same side as the thumb. The flow of these loops run in the direction of the radius bone, that is the downward slope of the radial loop is from the little finger toward the thumb of the hand. These loops are very common and most of the time will be found on the index. Second is ulnar loop. In this pattern, the ridges turn backward, but they don't make a full turn. To identify an ulnar loop, you will notice the loops moving toward the small finger. You will see these turns only if you view them on the hand and not to. Next subcategory is double loop. This pattern is consist of two distinct and separate loop formation. It has two distinct and separate shoulders for each core, two deltas and one more ridge that make a complete circle. There is at least one recurving ridge within the inner pattern area between the two loop formation that gets touched or cut when an imaginary line is. Third pattern is whorls. This can be found in about 25 to 35% of the fingerprint that are encountered. Some of the ridges in a whorl make a turn through at least one circuit. Therefore, any pattern that contains two or more delta will be a subcategories of whorl. First is plain whorl. The ridges in this whorl make a turn of one complete circuit with two deltas and are therefore circular or spiral in shape. There is a simplest form, a whirl, and also the most common. Second is central pocket loop whirl. This whirl consists of at least one recurving ridge or obstruction at right angle to the line of flow with two delta. And if any imaginary line is drawn in between, then no recurving ridge within the pattern area will be touched or cut. This whirl ridge may one complete circuit. It may be oval, circular, spiral, or any variant of. Third subcategory is accidental whirl. The composition of the pattern is accidental. Whirl is derived from two distinct type of pattern that have at least two deltas. Therefore, whirls containing ridge that match the characteristics of a particular whirl subgrouping are referred to as accidental whirl. Thank you for listening.